Reaction time is a measure of time a person takes to identify a stimulus and produce a response. For example, an athlete's audio reaction time is time elapsed between firing off gunshot and him or her starting the race. In this mini project, we create a reaction time meter that lets us measure reaction time for visual, audio, and touch stimuli. Let's get started. First of all, we will need a display to show reaction time measured. I'm using a small I2C OLED display for this purpose. A 5V Arduino Nano will act as brain for this mini project. For visual reaction time measurement, we will put a white circle on screen after a random delay. Person under test shall press red button as fast as he can on seeing this white circle. I connected I2C display, Arduino Nano, and two push buttons on a breadboard using bunch of jumper wires according to this schematic. Green push button is used to toggle among the type of reaction time measurements we have in this meter. For audio reaction time measurement, I added a buzzer to D7 pin of Arduino Nano. Buzzer goes off randomly, upon which user is supposed to press red button as soon as possible. For touch reaction time measurement, I am using a teared down relay with movable contact exposed. Movement of contact acts as touch stimuli. I connected coil of relay between ground and D8 pin of Arduino Nano. I am using a compact 9V battery to power this circuit, and adding an on-off switch completes the electronic hardware part of this meter. Let's take a look at Arduino code. I am using Adafruit GFX and SST1306 library to drive OLED. Before setup, we initialize all required variables, and in setup we initialize OLED, following which some information is displayed on screen. In loop function, green button is pulled to select menu item and screen is updated using update menu function. Once test is selected, load test function updates screen accordingly. Please go through this function on your own. Link to code is in the description. Once code and electronic hardware were ready, I drew approximate dimensions of OLED, relay, on-off and push button on a plastic box. Following that, I used hot blade to cut out these markings. Specially for buttonholes, I had to remove blade and use hot rod. To secure components on plastic box lead, I used glue gun and also used solder iron to secure few connections. Finally, I placed everything inside the enclosure and closed the lid. Let's take a demo of this mini project. But before that, if you like this video, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. I'll see you soon with another video. Till then, make a reaction time meter.